had in putting this little joystick into production was finding a way to interface between this Joy-Con replacement stick's carbon film connector and my microcontrollers. And in a previous video, I showed a whole bunch of different ways I was trying and got some good suggestions from people. And what got this into production without me having to do a whole heck of a lot of horrible soldering was a little breakout board. And one of my customers pointed it out to me. This little tiny breakout board, which is available from Four Layer Tech, for the number four and then the word layertech.com. They make this little joystick breakout board. And I think they sell it for about $2 for $6, which if you're needing this is fantastic. It's just such a time saver. It breaks out the five lines from the carbon cable. The cable plugs right in, so you're good to go. Now, what I have done is I worry about supply, right? Can I keep getting something? Especially if I need like 100 of something and it's no longer available, it really sucks. So what I did in collaboration with a friend of mine is developed this other breakout board, which is similar to the four layer one. It is bigger and the soldering points are further apart, because I found when I was assembling joysticks with the four layer board, the connections are really pretty close. It takes some pretty careful soldering, which is great if you're looking to minimize the size of things as much as possible. There's certainly nothing wrong with this. This has gone into a ton of joysticks, but it was slowing me down. And labor is my biggest cost when making joysticks for commercial sales. So had this board designed and manufactured. So the facility makes the board, puts the connector on, solders the connector. So I received these in a nice layout of a bunch of them. So now I know that I have my own source of supply for these boards. And I am making them available also on my Etsy store where I sell my joysticks. So you could purchase a set of four of these, and they're pretty handy. And to use either of these boards, what I do is I first cut and solder some short leads. In this case, I use silicone wire because it's more flexible, a little harder to work with until you get used to it. So solder it up like that. These will go to the microcontroller. And then from a cabling standpoint, it's a matter of, I always forget which way is which on these. There we go. Like that. And like that. And now you have something reasonable to work with. So in my sticks, I don't have one that's open right now. But what happens is I mount this into my enclosure and then hold it with two, I believe these are 1.6 millimeter screws for the stick itself. And then I mount this board, and I have a mounting post where I use a M2, I believe, fastener to hold it in place. So it gets kind of held right next to it. So you can kind of tuck it around or depending on your stick. So if you are doing work with the Joy-Con, either for ATEC work or just your own custom stick or just experimenting, I highly recommend saving yourself a lot of trouble and a lot of pain and purchase one of these breakout boards, whether it's from me or whether it's from Four Layer Tech. It's up to you. So that it's the way to go. It's already done. These five pin connectors are very hard to find. elsewhere. You see 4, you see 6, you see 10, not very many 5. So it's a little bit of a specialty item, but it is available. And the PCB design that I have is also completely open source. So if you want to have your own boards made, let me know and I will get you that information. Thanks for watching.